Hi everyone, today I am going to show you how you can work on Jupyter Notebook for Python and how you are going to work on Jupyter Notebook without installing Jupyter Notebook on your computer or PC. And you can also install that on any Windows operating system. I don't call that installation, but we are going to use a platform where we can work and we can use Jupyter Notebook, or simply we are going to use Notebook. Now here, what I need, I don't need anything, okay? You don't need any software, or you don't need any setup file. Just you have to come here, and you are going to write colab.research.google.com, okay? Once you are going to click colab.research.google.com, then you may get something similar to this one. And here you have everything which you are going to do with your Python or notebook, maybe Jupyter Notebook, but we call that Colab, and it is a platform by the google.com where you can use any packages. You don't need to install everything separately, but it is completely all in one package which you are going to work without any problem, and it will be easy for you to operate and use any package. Now I have different, you can see I have different files here already, but again you can see new notebook. When I'm going to click on new notebook, then it will load for me a new workplace like this one. You can see it is exactly similar with Jupyter Notebook, and here you have the title, which I'm going to just show you how to work or install, maybe install Jupyter Notebook, okay? And it is the title of, now you can see the title here. And one thing you are going to do, you have to connect and it will connect to the server or to the cloud in Google as well, and it is completely free. Don't forget that it is a free platform, and you can use that anytime, anywhere on the go. Now see, we have connected and we have a dedicated RAM and also disk, and which you can see that we have different platform connect to hosted run time or different other platform. We don't need anything right now, and we have a different RAM, and we have disk as well. Now you can see we have 12 GB of RAM here, and it is one of the best platform which I'm daily using for my machine learning platform. Now for example, if I'm going to write print, and here we are going to say hello world the famous code, okay, hello world, and enter, and you can see it will print everything here. Now if I want to just bring something like some sort of external maybe module or platform, then we are going to import that one as well. For example, for that purpose I'm going to use NumPy as np, and also panda, maybe pandas is pd, and maybe you are going to use import and going to import matplotlib dot p pyplot is plt, and also I'm going to import c born as sns, and we are going to enter, and it load everything. Now NumPy, if I'm going to just bring something like zeros, maybe 0 3 by 3, and you can see it is completely working fine. np dot maybe once, okay, maybe 4 5, and you can see it is generating everything. And if I'm going to add any maybe any random number, maybe np dot arrange maybe something 3 or 4, okay, And here we have like 3 or 4. And if I'm going to name that one like data, okay, and we are going to like call the data frame from Panda as well, pd.dataframe, and I'm going to call data frame, and here we are going to call data, and boom, here you have. Okay, now for example, if I'm going to name the column, and the column should be prices, and here you can see the price. Okay, how about if I'm going to like add one another data, for example data 2, np dot random, and we have random number dot, maybe I'm going to just for simplicity I'm going to bring something else like 4, maybe 5. Okay, 4, we are going to add data 2 as well, and here we are going to add 2 like. Okay, I have simply syntax error, and we are going to see that what is the problem. And okay, I have space in 2, I must not have that space in 2. Okay, and that is data 2 and that data 1. If I'm going to like see something here from data like np dot, if we have data 2 is na or dot sum, then we are going to see okay, we are going to see numpy array. Okay, it should be array, not object, has not attribute na, we don't have that array. Okay, then if I'm going to see what is the type of data 2, then we are going to see the type of data here, and it is numpy n dimension array. Okay, now here I just want to see you without installing anything. And for example, if you just leave that page, and another day you will come, or you are in any other place and you have access to internet, then you can again come to clip.research.google.com, then you can see how to install Jupyter Notebook, and it is here, and it is already installed, everything is already here, and you can just continue working on that project or machine learning or AI whatsoever you want. I hope that is the best way to work on notebook, on the go, on the cloud, as a Google platform. If you have any question, then you can ask me, and if you want to know that what is the difference between that offline and online notebook, then I can explain that for you as well. For now, if you like that video, just thumbs up and give me permission to say goodbye.